Praise the Lord. A very good morning to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning. Introduce yourself, my brother.
I'm Fabian. I was studying in Dubai for a little while. Then I went back to India to study too. Then, I'm not very sure about what I want to study right now. Not made up my mind. So, I'm looking to God to kind of direct me.
Amen. Today we have a wonderful, wonderful youth who has not made up his mind at all. What is going to happen to him in the future? What I am supposed to do in the future, right?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I mean, you don't have to feel worried. Oh my God, I have not yet made up my mind. What am I going to do, etc., etc. One thing is that your parents are responsible for this. Why? Why are they responsible? They made you very comfortable. Whatever happens, no problem at all. Man, you're there. No, Kalas, my parents. Listen, your parents are not going to be there forever. Correct?
Yeah.
Number one. Number two, what's your age now?
19.
You come to an age where you're standing on the threshold of, from here, I'm going to grow into be a man. Correct? Everybody is looking at a career. Correct? You have not made up your mind. You are in a better condition than the people who have started their career. Why? Because now you have one person who can direct you. Who is that?
God.
God. But God is very much in His kingdom. He is there ruling His kingdom and He is seeing that everything is in place there. People who have gone from here are there in heaven. He has to look after them. Correct? Both the Father and the Son are busy with that. Right? But they have given us somebody called the Holy Spirit. Now, listen to me very carefully. Today onwards, your prayer will be, Holy Spirit, I am a very confused man. I should say boy, you're not even a man as such, but okay. I am a very confused boy. And I went to a certain course. What was that course you did first?
Yes.
BSc. And I stopped halfway. Correct?
Yes.
Now I come back. Now I want to do? What do you want to do? CS. What is CS?
Company secretary.
Company secretary. So, again, I'm going there. Now, it's like this. You have put your leg on one stone here, then on the other stone there. Still, you're thinking, what will happen? After some time, you say, CS, no, it's boring. I don't want this. Let's go to something else. The best person to direct you will be the Holy Spirit. You have to, like what I said yesterday, get up in the morning and say, good morning, Holy Spirit. It's not a long prayer. Good morning, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for being with me. Now, show me where I'll be successful. Do you know something? God has blessed you with talents.
Yeah.
What are your talents now? As hobbies, I'm asking you.
I play a lot of sports.
Like what?
Football, basketball, volleyball.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Sports you play.
Yeah.
What else? Movies?
Yeah, I watch.
You love movies. The way you, the face came out, I love movies, man. Okay. What movies like? Hindi, Hindi, English?
English
movies. Okay. What about music?
Yeah, music too.
Music too. What is that you don't like? You got everything there. You, whatever I ask, you say yes. What else do you like? Do you do horse riding? Do you do karate?
I know how to horse ride.
You know, where did you learn horse riding?
So, I was in a military school. For some time, I wanted to...
Wow, which military school?
In Nasik, Bosa.
That trains you for that, I know.
Yeah.
It's very good, yes. And what else do you know? What else? I mean, you know all this. Do you drive a car?
No, not yet.
Not yet, okay. Fine. Now see, I'll tell you something. You have, Bosna Military School makes you tough.
Yeah.
It is not a regular run-of-the-mill stuff, you know. You go to school with your bag, study, come back home. Here they put you onto physical activities more than studies, if I'm not mistaken,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
What all they made you do? Do you horse riding then?
We used
then?
To run and like, we used to jog every morning.
Correct.
For a few kilometers.
Okay.
For 4 to 5 kilometers daily, and Saturday we used to have a long run.
Saturday like, a long run?
Yeah, 10, 15 kilometers.
Wow.
Yeah, and we used to have drills like march pass.
Yes.
Shooting.
Wow.
Yeah.
You shot anybody dead so far? No. No, you have not shot anybody dead, okay? Other people say, oh my God, I'm sitting next to a murderer. No, not at all. He's a nice boy, okay? Now, listen to me very carefully. listen to this piece of advice that I'm giving you, because I'm using all the time. I keep saying, Holy Spirit, meet me. Holy Spirit, take me there. And the Holy Spirit is making a way. But I never push it, you know, go and do it. No. So Holy Spirit, if it is God's will, let it happen. It is very important that the Holy Spirit comes into your life. Once the Holy Spirit comes into your life, you are there. Because then, you know, it's like this. Suppose you are moving at 20 kilometers an hour. Suddenly the Holy Spirit comes and takes you at 100 kilometers an hour. How do you feel? You achieved it, no? Otherwise you will be dragging yourself to your goal. But this will take you very close to the goal. And it will not only take you close to the career, but it will take you closer to God. The Holy Spirit has two duties. One is to keep you safe. One is to see that you go closer and closer and closer to the Lord. Am I correct? Yeah. How much close are you to the Lord? Be frank.
Not as much as I should be.
Okay. What do you do? Usually, do you pray only when you need it?
No, not even then.
Not even then, you don't pray at all?
Well, no. I don't go to Him when I need something at least. Like,
you don't go to Him? No.
I don't think that's right, so I don't do that.
Okay.
So, but yeah, I ask Him sometimes to change me, like change my mindset at least.
Okay. So pray for. Yeah. But do you pray every day?
No.
Once in about how many days?
No, whenever I'm in church, I pray. Whenever we go to church.
But at home?
No.
Never have you prayed at
home? No, we used to pray a lot. Like, we had family prayers, so then I used to say my prayer, like my own short prayer, along with the family prayer. But yeah, after going to India, like staying alone there,
I lost. Okay. Now you come back to the family.
Yeah.
So you're praying again.
Yeah. Not every day, but yeah,
praying.
Yeah.
Okay. Listen. To be successful in life, I'll give you small things. One rosary is a must every day. Mother Mary is with you. It's like your mother, Veronica. Mm. When she is around you, how comfortable do you feel that you can go and ask your mother everything? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Correct? And your father in heaven, your father here on earth is Mark. What about him? He's always there for you, correct?
Yeah.
Both are very loving people. I know them very well. Both are very loving people, but they are always there for you. That comfort zone is something that they should push you out of. You know what? In the Western countries, when you reach the age of 18, you're thrown out of the house.
Yeah.
You know that?
Yeah.
Yeah? And there's no question of papa, mama, no. You're on the road. If you have to survive, you have to work, you have to earn, and you have to live. Correct? So, my dear friend, it's time to get out of the comfort zone, but take the Holy Spirit with you. Take the Holy Spirit and go out. And all those youth who are listening to us, please understand, without prayers, life is nothing. You have to pray every day. The rosary is a must. Rosary, whether it is more important, you pray with the family, because a family that prays together, lives together, loves together, it's just a wonderful family. But if you are scattered, there is no unity in that family. And the love that comes after prayers is that you are fond of each other, you love each other. And that is exactly what you all should look at. You all should set a time aside. 8 o'clock. Whatever time. What time does Judy come back from work?
7:30.
Yeah, 7:30. So 8 o'clock. Sit and say the rosary. All four together. And then you are on your personal trip with the Holy Spirit. Morning, get up. Holy Spirit, good morning. I don't know what to do, Holy Spirit. What do you think? Holy Spirit will show you something to be done. The Holy Spirit is very powerful. If you understand the power of the Holy Spirit, you will be a winner, you will be a successful person. Amen? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we surrender this young lad to you, Father God. This precious child of yours. Father God, soak him with your most precious blood. Protect him from all evil and danger. Lord, the youth of today, my Father, they've been lured away by a lot of things that they see in this world. May they not be seeing a lot of these things, Father God. May they realize that you are the way, the truth and the life. Holy Spirit, Spirit of God, take charge and take control of his life so that he becomes very successful, not only in this world, but in that spiritual world where he can attain that beautiful kingdom and come to you one day once his mission on earth is complete. For yours the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you very much. Say bye to them.
Bye bye. Thank you.
Very good.